This is Guglielmo, and today we are in Syracuse, in Italy, a beautiful city, as you can see from the video. And we had a really beautiful run with the new Adidas Supernova Plus. This is a pair of shoes that I bought with my money. No one is paying me for this review. So as usual, I will mention pros and cons of the shoe, which I hope can support you to decide which shoe to buy. If you like the video, don't forget to leave a like. And if you don't want to miss any new video and support the channel, activate the notification bell and subscribe. This is really important for the channel, and it is just one click in the subscribe button here below. So if you usually watch the video, you will support the channel with just one click and for free. So let's do it. If you want to know in advance which shoe I'm reviewing and which training I'm currently doing, you can follow me on Instagram or on Strava, where I usually put all my tests and trainings in almost every day. Say that, let's talk about the Supernova Plus. I hope you can hear me because they're a little bit windy. Well, the Supernova Plus is a road neutral shoe of 10mm drop, 32mm in the heel, 22mm in the forefoot, and with a weight of 11 ounces, 312 grams in the US 9 sides in the male version, and 10.5 ounces, 298 grams in the US 7.5 sides in the female version. We have seen in the channel several lightweight running shoes, but we also need a recovery shoe for our slow or recovery runs. For instance, the day after tough training, where it is really important to wear a stable shoe, especially because we are tired and we need more support to avoid injuries. And therefore, I found a great deal with the Supernova Plus. You can find it for less than 100 euro. And I decided to review it because all of us need a recovery shoe in our rotation. Even though we know that the shoe is not made for running fast, I collected as usual the running dynamic metric using my Garmin HRM strap at different paces, because I was also curious to see and understand the differences with the other shoes. So let's go quickly through it. The two running dynamic metrics that I collected as usual are the average ground contact time, which is the time between the first part of the foot touch the ground and the last part of your foot leaves the ground. Lower ground contact time indicates a better efficiency and responsiveness of the shoe. The second metric that I usually collect is the vertical oscillation ratio, which is the ratio between the oscillation and the stride length, which should be less than 10% in order to be more efficient and avoid too much vertical oscillation. And here you can see the different values collected and the comparison with other shoes, and you can notice for which pace the shoe is better in the 5 tests executed at different paces that you can see in the table here in the left hand side. Looking to the vertical oscillation ratio measured, the Supernova Plus has a similar value range as the ASICS EVO Ride 2 for all the paces tested, and which is below 10%, so ensured to me a good efficiency. And surprisingly, as you can see, marked here in green, the response is better than expected, increasing the speed, because the ground contact time decreases to another 90 milliseconds, meaning the bounce foam with the classical EVA foam is still performing well. Outsole now. Let's move to talk about the outsole, which is a sole covered with a lot of rubber from heel to toe. Basically, there is not exposed foam. It is not the continental rubber, but on dry, wet and gravel path, it was performing good in terms of grip. The rubber contributes to the stiffness of the shoe, but it is not an hard rubber. You can even notice it from the sound test. That confirms also the grip evaluation. There are no premature signs so wear, and the prediction is that it will last longer. In any case, we will see it in the 100 miles review video, which will be uploaded as soon as I will reach this mileage. The good thing is that it doesn't collect stones, but it is not that flexible. Rather really stable, even though we don't have a torsion system, but we have the bounce midsole foam which support and avoid the torsions of the foot. The forefoot and the heel are pretty large to ensure a better stability. You can notice the difference with the Adios 6 that of course contribute to increase the weight of the shoe. The outsole is so flat that the shoe is so stable that can be used also in the gym for the straightening exercises. Nothing more to say about the outsole, which overall I like for such kind of shoe.
midsole now.
The midsole is made of two different foams, the bounce and the boost foam, which is placed also in the forefoot because this is the Supernova Plus, while in the Supernova we don't have the boost in the forefoot, so pay attention to it when you buy the shoe. The boost foam is well known for a great return of energy and for the cushioning, which improves the comfort. For the boost foam, we have measured the harshness here in the list. As you can see, it's one of the softer foam I'm currently running with. Unfortunately, for the position of the bounce foam in the shoe, I wasn't able to measure it properly, but for sure it is stiffer than the boost foam and helps in terms of stability, but also provide a good spring to the shoe because it is extended all throughout the shoe in a single piece of foam. The boost foam instead is composed by two different foam pieces, the forefoot on top of the bounce foam and in the heel under the bounce foam. This solution worked well because I found the shoe really comfortable in the forefoot, but especially in the heel, really important for a recovery shoe. The bounce material technology is made using the classical Heva foam, which was the industry standard for performance shoes. The boost foam was about to change all, introducing a midsole made from a thousand of expanded particles that works together to deliver a better energy return and comfort in every stride. The boost foam has been used in several shoes and now especially in the performance shoes has been replaced with the light strike foam because lighter and more responsive in feel but less comfortable. So we are now in the light strike era, which is really not a good era for who loves the boost foam. So we basically talk about the material used in the midsole, which has a quite flat profile. Unfortunately, it doesn't guide and support the heel-to-toe transition, but I believe it is not an issue for a recovery shoe.
Upper now.
Jumping to talk about the upper, it is a lightweight, breathable, 100% recycled polyester mesh upper, which creates flexibility and support. I like this upper because it leaves the right room in the forefoot. At the same time, it really wraps well the foot because it is not too loose. I tested it in a warm day, more than 30 degrees Celsius, and it is breathable, especially in the forefoot. It has a reinforced mesh and some overlay materials to give a little bit of extra support in the toe area and in the back of the shoe. Which is of course less breathable. The heel cap is tall and delivers great support for the heel and Achilles tendon. It is covered with a soft fabric and therefore doesn't annoy the delicate skin around the Achilles tendon. This makes the running shoes ideal for people that sometimes suffer from irritation around the Achilles tendon. You have to pay attention to the first time you use the shoe. To adjust well the lockdown because the lockdown system is pretty wide and the laces are not that long. Even aesthetically speaking, it is a nice upper. I must say I really like it. There is attention to the details when it comes to design. I could easily see myself using these running shoes as a sneakers too, as the design is minimalistic with the different colors, so you can enjoy the wide array of choices. The shoe fits through two sides, the laces are traditional and the lockdown system is working well, thanks also to the good tongues, which is wide and thin but with a good padding, especially in the middle. It was comfortable. It is not anchored on the sides, but it keeps its position because it is wide. In the lockdown system, we have still these nylon rings, which I don't like, but which are more flexible and therefore most likely improve the lockdown. But I don't know how long they will last. So in conclusion, considering the running dynamic metrics collected and my first impressions, I believe that the Supernova Plus is a good quality daily trainer to use, especially for slow runs, not for long distances because the weight. Yes, the shoe is on the heavy side, so if we use it for long distances, we could feel it a little bit. Therefore, I wouldn't suggest to use this shoe for long distances. But on the other hand, it's perfect for recovery days or even for the special days when we have to do our straightening exercises for the legs. For instance, for using the press, is perfect due to the fully flat profile of the outsole. So it is a really important shoe for our rotation. We all should have such kind of shoe in our rotation to show the stability we need in the day after a tough training where we need it. Being this budget shoe made especially for this purpose, I believe that it is a great shoe with quality materials used with a nice look, which is also important. So guys, this is it for today. If you liked the video, please don't forget to leave a like and to hit the subscribe button here below. It will not cost anything to you, just one click, but it will be a great support for the channel. And if you don't want to miss any new video, because I don't know if YouTube will propose to you my video, then please activate the notification here below and you will stay tuned with us. As usual, thanks for watching and I'll see you soon in the next video.